It's easier not to believe in the things you cannot see, to explain away every strange occurrence as something a little less strange. That's not a UFO, that's ball lightning, or swamp gas, or a weather balloon. That's an airplane, or a meteor, or Venus. As for that footprint in the woods, that's a bear track, or a wolf track, or any track that helps you sleep better at night. For a year now, I've tried to find answers beyond ball lightning and swamp gas and weather balloons. I've dispensed with the bear tracks and the wolf tracks in search of something stranger. What is it about the unknown that proves so tantalizing? What happens when we hit the road, crack the books, and listen to people whose voices are often muted? This is my story of hitting that road, cracking those books, and learning to listen. It's a story, too, about spending a year amid the strangest tales the Midwest has to offer. And not just to be fascinated by them, but to explore the curious nature of our fascination, too. As a result of my journeys, I'm now compelled to view the world differently, to spend more time nodding my head than rolling my eyes, more time asking questions than answering them. I've selected the Midwest as my testing ground because, as a Midwesterner, I'm well versed in our region's oddities. And I'm well aware, too, that most people aren't. We middle Americans have grown accustomed to being overlooked, which is precisely why outsiders ought to look a bit closer. My search for the strange took me directly into this heartland. I struck out for the back roads and the watering holes found off the beaten path, anxious to hear the stories rarely recounted in the visitor centers. Each of the stories left me more baffled than before, but reminded me too that the greatest mystery is our capacity for wonder.